Okay, guys. We'll take a little bit of a ride around the block and test out this wind guard that I made. And along the way, I gotta explain a few things that I experienced on my first run. God, it's hard getting a pair of glasses on in a helmet when you're riding. Okay. I'm just putting on my chin strap, hang on. And then we'll take a nice little ride. Today's a good day to test it too, by the way, because it's kind of windy. If you can see the trees over there in front of us, they kind of got a good little breeze going, so. Alright. So, I'm not going to stop at this point. I'm just going to go ahead and keep recording. I think I got the iPhone 4S aimed where I want it, so you guys can see a pretty good view. I got the mic on, and the face shield is closed. I got my volume set to medium on the iPhone 4S, because I didn't know if that made a difference on the sound quality. I thought maybe if I had it full blown, that's probably what was causing some of the distortion. What else? That's it. So let me explain a few things that happened when I put the helmet on after I showed you guys that video with the material that I was using. I didn't take into consideration how big my head was. I wear an extra large helmet, and I probably should have done some better measurements, but you know, when you do things like this, you know, do-it-yourself mods and whatnot, it's a learning experience. Anyway, so what I did was, when I put the helmet on, it was a real tight fit, so I forced my head through. Was here because it still held on. It maintained holding holding onto the helmet where I had placed it, but it just ended up ripping because my damn head was too big. So the simple fix for that was, I just shortened the length. And what I mean by that is that I didn't have it extend so far out near my mouth. I kind of just barely covered the front tip of the helmet. And that's what we're going to test this with. I've also included some pictures of the length that I have it now. And we'll see how this works out. Now, I can tell you right now, I mean, of course I won't know till I play the video back for you guys, but I remember the first time I put the iPhone 4S on the helmet and I did a test run for you guys, I can hear a hell of a lot of wind disturbance, and I don't hear it as much now, so that might be a plus. I was going to, when I saw it rip like that, I got upset and I was like, shit, man, that didn't work, you know, like I thought it was. And I was going to go out and buy some felt, because it's more of like a fabric. But what I don't like about the felt is that it's got so many thin fibers that's embedded in it that the wind, in my opinion, the wind would just go right through it. Whereas the material I'm using, like I said, it's got a rubber type feel to it. There's nowhere for air to go to pass through it, like felt would. So, I looked at what happened, and I said, well, shit, how can I fix this problem? And I said, well, you know what? I bet you anything I made it too damn big, and with my big old head, trying to force my head on there just didn't work. It ripped it. So I decided to go ahead and just shorten it up a bit. And And we'll find out what the results are. But anyway, we take a nice little ride just around the block, around the neighborhood, see what's going on, and then test this mic out and see how that works out. Take this road right here. It's got a nice little... Man, the park's full today because it's a beautiful day. I don't know if y'all saw to the left of me, that's a park. Oh yeah, open road. Yeah, so I'm telling you, I don't hear any of the wind disturbance like I was before. It's funny that a little tiny piece of material like that underneath the helmet can make a huge difference in the airflow that gets into the helmet. But we'll check it out here in a minute and we'll see what's going on. Hope you guys are doing well out there, all of you. I've got a real exciting video coming up and I'm really excited about it, man. It's going to be awesome. I will tell you this much without giving too much away, but it involves the Dolby drone by ZeroTech. That's all I'm going to say, but it's going to be an awesome video, I think, especially for anyone that's a modder. You're going to love it. I just hope everything works out according to how I have it all in my head. We'll see. Oh yeah. Calm down, guy. I'm coming in. There you go. I guess we should take it on the highway. I mean, these are just back roads. We're not getting a whole lot of wind coming through. Oh shoot, I can't turn to the left. That sucks. I guess I'll have to go further down and do a turnaround. I could break the law. Fuck it. Y'all didn't see that. Told you guys I live near the airport. That's the airport straight ahead. Yeah, I want to take it on the highway here, see what the sound quality is going to be, because of course we're going to pick up a lot of wind. I don't even know how much video recording time I got on the iPhone 4S. I didn't give it a full charge. I was kind of busy working on another project today, and I just kind of did this at the last minute because I remembered. I said, oh shoot, I told everyone I was going to put a video up with the results by Saturday, so I'm a man of my word. I didn't want to let you guys.